Hi, Paul Donovan here from avtechnician.ca, your channel for tips and tricks for AV technicians. Today I want to talk about a VGA distribution amp. Well, not just VGA, I'm also going to briefly talk about HDMI. A lot of times in AV world we have to take a signal off of a laptop or other video production item and send it out and split it off into multiple monitors. And so we need some way to distribute the signal. Now, you know, some people might think, well, I just put a splitter in there. But unfortunately, VGA and HDMI signals don't like the concept of just being split. They like a little bit of technology in between to help make sure the signal stays good. The simple VGA DA distribution amplifier is relatively cheap. You can get them 2, 4, 6, 8, many different split outs if you've got a lot of TVs going all over the place. The lower cost ones do provide a small amount of, just a little bit of amplification of the signal, which is handy if your laptop is running to the distribution amp that's maybe 50, 75, 100 feet away, and you don't have a big signal coming from the laptop in the first place. It gets to the amplifier takes that signal and just very slightly augments it so it can transfer through the cables out to the projectors and monitors and so on. It is a small advantage, but it's something I have done where I've had a poor signal coming off a laptop. I've actually put a DA at the tech table where I'm not actually splitting it. I'm just feeding the feed in, letting the little tiny amplification of that box amplify it enough to power it up to the run out to the distribution amp that is actually being split for the monitors and projectors. Now, a lot of times nowadays, we're seeing the use, instead of running a VGA cable a long distance, we're seeing repeaters that are happening now that use Cat5 cabling. This is a new trend, quite reliable, and it gives you a greater distance to be able to transmit your signal. Very little signal loss in the course of transmitting through the Cat5 network cable. These devices are varying in prices and becoming more popular, and you can often get some of the lower priced ones. Oh, as little as $150 for the both ends, the send and receive ends. Now, a lot of laptops today are coming without a VGA connector on the laptop, and so all you have is an HDMI. Now, a good smart AV technician should keep in his little pocket, should keep a little dongle, a little adapter that goes from HDMI out to VGA. You can get these adapters relatively cheap. They're great. But do remember two things, or one thing for sure. HDMI, by default, carries the audio signal with it as well. So if you're just converting the HDMI signal to VGA, you are not receiving the audio signal because VGA does not transmit audio. So sometimes you'll see VGA to HDMI to VGA converters where they actually have an extra jack port where you can plug in some RCA audio cables to get audio off of the jack. That's handy, but it's not common, and it's sometimes sort of like, should I do it or should I not? But all you got to do is go to the laptop's sound settings, and instead of having it go through the HDMI cable output, choose for it to go out, say, the headphone jack or the speakers built in or whatever way you want the sound to go. But do remember to turn it back again for your poor customer later when the next time they plug in an HDMI cable and they don't get any sound, because most laptops will remember how things were set the last time it was used. The other thing we sometimes see is a VGA distribution amplifier, or DA, that is what's called a matrix. It has the ability of taking the signals coming in. Sometimes the ones I've worked with have been two signals coming in and four signals going out. What that does is you can actually send in two separate signals and fire off those signals to any of the four jacks. So if you want to have the right screen and the left screen having different things, you would feed A and B from laptop A to A on the matrix DA and B to the B jack, and then you push one of the four buttons to determine the A is going to go onto the left screen and left monitor, and the B is going to go onto the right screen and the right monitor. Here in Canada, where we have a federal government that is required to do things in two languages, two official languages, it's not uncommon for us to have a right screen in English and a left screen in French, or left or right, doesn't really matter. But it's not uncommon, and two laptops that have to be controlled by independent English and French PowerPoint. So it's not uncommon for us, and when we do work with the federal government, that we have split-screen scenario. And so a split-screen matrix DA is often very handy. It's really no different than a regular DA if you've only got a single source, but you do have to be careful to be sure that you choose your four outputs to choose to off of that single source. You'd be surprised how many times our guys have set up our little matrix one, and they forget to push the button to activate the screen, and they're like, why is there no signal on the projector? And it works. Distribution amps are not expensive. There are some really expensive ones you can get. HDMI distribution amplifiers are a little more expensive just because the technology of HDMI signal transmission is a little more enhanced. But they're not extremely expensive. But I'm surprised that lately that AV companies are still sticking to the VGA signal a lot of times. And while there's usually no problem with a VGA signal, it really comes into things as when you convert an HDMI signal to a VGA, there is a little bit of signal loss that happens there. Sometimes you may lose some of the extreme clarity and so on. So there you have it, distribution amplifiers for the AV industries. Paul Donovan here from avtechnician.ca. Thank you for coming and watching again. Tips and tricks for AV technicians. Please click like. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Our website, www.avtechnician.ca. Please go there and check out tips and tricks for AV technicians. Have a great day, and thank you for watching.